Welcome to The Magicians, brought to you by the Creepy Little Book channel here on YouTube. I am Peter McCarthy, and to my left,
I'm Elena Wright.
We look back through history at the men and women whose work, beliefs, or ideas would come to shape what we consider the occult. And today we're going to look at Apollonius of Tyana. So Apollonius of Tyana lived around the same time as the biblical Jesus. Not only Jesus, but another character from the Bible as well.
And that would be Paul.
That's Paul. And in fact, their stories are very similar. Paul does a lot of traveling. Likewise, so does Apollonius. But let's break this down from the very beginning. Much like Jesus, Apollonius' birth is a pretty big deal.
It's a miracle. Yeah. He was born to a virgin.
Yep.
He also had, would you say willing creatures? Or
it
would
was
you
swans. I believe it's swans. Okay. His mother wakes from a dream and is told to go out into a meadow where she goes into labor. And a flock of swans comes down and circle her, and they're flapping their wings.
Sort of like the three wise men, but they're swans.
They're coming down to pay homage to his birth. During the story of Jesus' nativity, we have the star in the sky, the star of Bethlehem. There was also a sign in the sky when Apollonius was born.
A lightning bolt.
This lightning bolt shoots on down and curves back up before it ever hits anything, marking that even the gods recognize the uniqueness of this person. So Apollonius, he's born into a wealthy family.
Yeah, he didn't come from a poor section.
He's really smart for his age.
Mm-hmm. He's a genius boy.
So his father sends him off for further education in Turkey, off to one of these temples, which would be one of the mystery schools that we've talked about in previous videos. And much like Jesus and his story in the temple in the Bible, he's the smartest person at the school, he's smarter than the teachers. So Apollonius at 16 becomes an initiate in the mystery school. This is where Apollonius makes decisions that forever change his life, and those are really have to do with his lifestyle.
He doesn't have sex, he doesn't drink, he is very, very clean. Clean living.
Apollonius takes his vow of silence. 5 years, Apollonius doesn't say a word.
Doesn't say a word.
And then he begins his travels. And much like the biblical Paul who we mentioned, he travels far and wide, all through Asia Minor. He travels to India. And when he returns back, he brings these ideas and beliefs that he picked up along the way with him. He kind of gets a pretty big following. He's got disciples like Jesus who are following him around. He's speaking to multitudes of crowds. But one thing that makes him stand out like Jesus is he performs
miracles.
Miracles, yeah.
He heals the sick. He casts out evil if people are possessed. And there's one tale he brings back a child of a high stature Roman.
Right, he brings his child back from the dead. So Apollonius, his miracles parallel the very same miracles of Jesus. Apollonius, of course, there were people that weren't too thrilled with him, and they would say negative things about him, such as he was a
wizard, a sorcerer, and those were condemnable labels back then.
He would come up against the Roman Empire a few times, but Apollonius tends to come out on top every time he runs into these issues. Whereas Jesus only lived for 33 years before his crucifixion, Apollonius, they say, lived to be about 100. He lived for a long time. But there are a lot of parallels between these two figures. Even so, as they say that Apollonius appeared to his followers after his death, just like Jesus does in the story of the Gospels. So, this is a really interesting character who almost completely forgotten by history.
Jesus kind of stole Apollonius' fire.
And there was a time when Apollonius did have temples dedicated to him all over the Roman Empire. I mean, he was a pretty well-known and well-worshipped figure. This would cause controversy centuries later when Christians would accuse the followers of Apollonius of stealing the story of Jesus. Likewise, the followers of Apollonius would say the Christians stole their story and changed
stole our stories. No, you stole our stories.
Yeah. And that would go back and forth. One way or another, these two contemporaries living at the same time in the same region of the world, with a lot of the same similar characteristics ascribed to them, would both go down in history, but one would be vastly well remembered, while the other would kind of fade
by the wayside
into obscurity. But fortunately, you have shows like ours to bring this interesting information to you. So I guess I want to say thanks everybody for watching the show this week.
Share and subscribe.
Don't forget to do that. Stay creeped out.